हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, स्टैंडर्ड 8 केमिस्ट्री चैप्टर नंबर 6 कंबसन एंड फ्लेम। इन द लास्ट सेशन वी लर्न व्हाट इज एक्चुअली कंबसन। कंबसन इज अ केमिकल प्रोसेस इन विच द सब्सटेंस react with oxygen to produce heat and sometimes heat and light together. Thus combustion is actually the process of burning. Sometimes we know that like a magnesium ribbon, when it burns, it produces magnesium dioxide. That is an example of combustion process. Then we talked about the conditions for combustion, means which conditions are that such that the combustion can take place. There was a fuel, continuous supply of fuel or a combusting material. If fuel is finished, combustion cannot take place. If the material is not combustible material, also combustion cannot take place. Second thing is adequate amount of oxygen or air, because in absence of air, that cannot take place combustion. So second thing is continuous supply of oxygen, and that also we learn with that activity that we take a candle, lighted candle, and put it there. Then on it we covered with the chimney. In first case we put two wooden blocks under the chimney so that there is a gap between the surface of the table and the chimney so that the oxygen can enter. In this situation, candle was burning. In second situation, we took out that wooden blocks so the chimney was in the contact with the table, and therefore oxygen supply was not adequate, because only from the top and we from where oxygen and carbon dioxide are also going out, therefore not enough oxygen is getting, therefore that flame is flickering, not steady flame will be there. And in the last, when we covered that chimney with a cardboard, then totally oxygen supply was cut, no new air was going in. So in this situation, the candle will blow off. And the third requirement is the ignition temperature, because any substance cannot catch fire, cannot burn below the ignition temperature. Ignition temperature is the lowest temperature at which a substance can catch fire. So these are the three conditions. It means that if we want to put out the fire, put off the fire, we must cut any one or more than one conditions. For example, if we cut the connection between the fuel and the oxygen, fuel, we will take it out, then it cannot burn because there is no fuel, no combustible material. Second thing, we can cut the supply of oxygen. Maybe you have seen that sometimes in the houses, when somebody's body catches fire, the clothes, then what do? They cover that person with a blanket such that the connection of oxygen will be cut and you can easily put out that fire. Therefore, blanket is covered on the body such that it cannot supply the oxygen. Now, you have heard about maybe forest fire. Now and then we are listening about it in the forest of Amazons and somewhere else in Australia, and in recently also there was a fire. What is actually forest fire? We know that sometimes when there is very very hot weather, so due to the very very extreme heat of summer, at some place the temperature goes up and therefore the dry grass have low ignition temperature, so they will catch the fire first due to the high temperature. They can start fire, catch fire, and then that fire from the dry grass, it can spread to the surrounding plants and trees. And then you know that within the few minutes it can spread all over the forest, because there will be adequate amount of oxygen that can work. Wind also, the wind can also spread it, and that is known as forest fire. Now it is very very difficult to control that fire, because we cannot cut anything of the three conditions. Fuel, the whole forest is a fuel, because it is wood and wooden material, everything. So we cannot take off that things. Second thing, supply of oxygen. How can we control the supply of oxygen in the whole forest? Third thing, ignition temperature also we cannot come down. We cannot bring down the temperature also. So it is very very difficult to control that forest fire. And I already explained you about this thing, that the clothes of a person catches fire, then we cover it with candle. Maybe then other things, when in the villages, we know that people use wood for the cooking also, or to make water hot for bathing and some other thing. So generally, to burn that wood, first they will use some kerosene oil. Why? Why not directly they are putting fire to the wood? Because we, as we talked about it, that ignition temperature is needed to catch fire. The temperature must be at the ignition temperature. Now, if the substance's ignition temperature is low, that can start burning first. And then, whose ignition temperature is higher than that, that can be burned later. So if we compare the ignition temperature of wood and kerosene oil, then the ignition temperature of kerosene oil is very low compared to the ignition temperature of wood. So first we use some kerosene, spread over it, and then we burn it with the matchstick. So the ignition temperature of kerosene is lower, and therefore it can catch fire quickly. And then in that fire, the wood is getting hot, and then its ignition temperature will be maintained, and then the wood also will start burning. So for this situation, they have to use that kerosene oil, so that that kerosene oil can start the ignition. And therefore, other things, why don't we use generally kerosene in that stove for the cooking? Why don't we use petrol or diesel for that purpose? Can you think about it? because petrol and diesel are having low ignition temperature than the kerosene also, and therefore there are chances of making an accident with the fire, and therefore we don't use that diesel or petrol in the stove. We have to use the kerosene only. Now you know that when we use matchsticks were found nearly only 200 years ago. Before that they were using some pieces of pine wood dipped in sulfur, but it was not safe. They were taking the wood of the pine trees, pine wood, and they were dipping it into the sulfur, and then they were using that to catch the fire. But that was very dangerous. It was not safe. So now the safety matches, આપણે એને safety matches તરીકે ઓળખીએ છીએ. લખેલું ભી હશે, વાંચો તમે safety matches. Because they are safe to use. We can control it. Therefore, its name is matchstick. So this matchstick that we are using is found only nearly 200 years ago. Now, what are the chemicals that are using to make that matchstick? Look here. A wooden matchstick has mixture of antimony trisulfide and potassium chlorate at its head. You know more that matchstick. On the matchstick, on the top of that wooden matchstick, there is a mixture of these two things, antimony trisulfide, and what is the other thing is potassium chlorate. So on that matchstick, you know that there is a black colored something is there, or sometimes red also. It is the mixture of those two things, antimony trisulfide and potassium chlorate, which is stick with the use of a little glue on that matchstick. Now that matchstick also cannot burn itself. Why does not it burn itself? Why we have to rub it, then only it can start burning? Because the ignition temperature of that material used is not maintained at the room temperature. It is little higher than the room temperature, so it cannot catch fire itself. We have to rub it against that rub material which is on the side of the matchbox. So on the side of matchbox you will see that it is rough. If you touch that thing, it is rough. On which a powdered glass is made powder, and that along with some red phosphorus, that is on the side of that matchbox. And then what we do, because of that surface is rough, when we take out the matchstick and rub it against that rough surface, what happens? Look here. That red phosphorus, some of the red phosphorus converts into white phosphorus. And white phosphorus is very, very active. And that will react with the potassium chlorate. It reacts with potassium chlorate. So, that process is producing heat, and that heat is enough to bring the temperature of antimony trisulfide to have its ignition point. ignition temperature. So that temperature is enough to ignite that antimony tri sulfide, and then it catches fire. So what happens? I'm gonna repeat again that when we rub that matchstick against that rough surface, what is there on the rough surface? Red phosphorus. So by rubbing, the red phosphorus turns into white phosphorus, which is very very reactive, and it will react with this potassium chlorate. This process is producing some heat, and that heat takes the temperature of antimony trisulfide to its ignition temperature. And when the ignition temperature is maintained, what will it do? It will catch fire. And therefore, the antimony trisulfate catch fire, which is enough for the combustion process to start. So by this way, the matches cannot burn itself, because the temperature should go up until the ignition temperature. And this is the story of our modern matchsticks. So now we are going to finish today's session. In next session, we will learn about some highly inflammable substances. What are the causes of fire? How can we control the fire? Etc. etc. Now you have to write down whatever you get in the PDF file, and any query write down in the comment section. Thank you very much.